Good Thursday evening, everybody. Welcome to the scene. I'm Jamarcus Gaston.
And I'm Megan Heidelberg. Happy Friday Eve.
Friday Eve. I love it. I love it. So this one is a first on scene tonight. We've been talking about it, and I know people at home are going to be talking about it as well.
This is so cool. A woman born and raised in Greenville has been growing out her fingernails for nearly 30 years, and her longest one, Jamarcus, is just over 18 inches.
18 inches, and of course, she's gotten a lot of questions over the years, so now she's finally answering them all in an exclusive interview with Scene. Jennifer Martin has her story.
I do everything that everybody else does. I just happen to be a lady with long fingernails.
I love it.
30 years ago, Angie Stewart made a vow to let her fingernails grow wild.
My grandmother, she had long ones, probably maybe a little shorter than this or probably this length. And when she died, I just thought that that would be a great way to remember her by her nails. And I was, you know, I just always felt as long as I had my nails, I had her.
Now she says they're a part of her.
They just my babies.
At the moment, her longest nail measures over 18 inches.
The longest that they have gotten was 28 inches.
Still, she insists that everyday tasks are easy.
I really don't notice. Every day I put on contact lens, and I just put them on, you know, by myself. The funny part about it is, it's harder for me to do stuff with this hand than it is with this hand.
Much of the day is spent typing, believe it or not, working as a college transfer coordinator and customer service rep for a tech company.
People think that I live like this all day. I don't work. I don't do anything. But little do they know, I have two jobs. I'm working on a master's degree.
To keep her nails strong, Angie visits her nail tech once a month.
I want them filed a certain way. I don't want no lumps, no humps in them. I want them nice and clean.
The same one she's been seeing for 20 years.
Now the polish part takes about an hour just to polish her nails. We have to stand up to do that.
It's a process that can take up to 5 hours.
It's like a teamwork job. I do the filing.
She does the buffing. If not, I don't think I'd survive 20 years later.
Even though she's used to working around them, it's not always easy.
After your nails get so long, nerve endings do grow in the nails. You can hit a nail and it won't break, and it'll feel like you broke your finger, your arm, your leg, and everything else, and you wish the nail had broke.
And most days are filled with double takes.
I walk past, everybody stop. All of a sudden, all these cell phones come out. People are trying to snap pictures. It's just like a celebrity walking in a room. And I mean, it can get crazy sometimes.
But Angie says they're here to stay.
My nails are a part of me, and when I look at my nails, I think of my grandmother.
For Scene, I'm Jennifer Martin.
And Angie joins us in studio now. Thank you for choosing Scene to tell your story.
Thank you.
I met you at Fall for Greenville, and I was kind of like reluctant. I'm like, how do I approach her and not acknowledge the nails? How do you want people to do it? You know, everyone's taking out their cell phones and pictures and stuff. Is that hurtful? Does it make you feel good?
Depends on the scene.
How they do it.
The way they do it and the scene that I'm in. You know, I don't want to be bombarded. And I, you know, people like, I don't, do she wash or something? I just don't want you running up touching me.
Right.
Right.
You know, because I, you know, but I try to be nice.
Because you wouldn't do that to anyone else, so and, why would you do
yeah,
it to you?
Yeah. Yeah, and I'm very nice, though, with kids.
Yeah.
I love kids, so when they come up, you know, I'm welcome. It just depends on the way someone approaches me.
And where their heart is.
Yes.
To know about
yes.
it, too.
But I love people, so I love talking to people.
And you don't mind people taking, like, asking to take a picture with you because they're your pride and joy, and you don't
correct.
Mind people seeing them, but this is a respectful way.
Yeah.
Of doing it, because we have people online that were like, you know, you get a lot of online trolls that are like this, that, and the other. But I mean, it's a part of you.
Yeah, it's a part of me, but people don't understand, and this is the reason why today I decided to tell the story, because I feel like people say stuff because they don't know.
Right.
So this is a way to educate people. Mm-hmm. People with long nails are just like everyday people. You know, I just happen to be a woman with long nails, but I do everything everybody else do. Mm-hmm. I'm educated. I'm clean. I'm just, you know, I'm just a normal
person. About to finish your master's degree. And
master's degree in the summer.
That's awesome. That is impressive. All right, let's do some girl talk.
Okay.
Are they heavy?
I
I don't know, because see, this is the thing. It's I grew them, so it's not like all of a sudden one day you have a long nail.
Right.
They just gradually growing. So people ask me, you know, are they heavy? I don't know. I
just tell they've been a part of you.
Yeah, because
right?
They've been a part of me for so long. So I'm like, I don't know. I mean, they just normal to me.
If you get nervous, you never get the urge to
But sometimes I'm somewhere and someone will be staring at me and I'm like, what? What's wrong?
What's wrong with me? They're like, you know, like, oh.
And then I'm like, okay, the nails.
Yeah. And people ask, like, do you have help getting dressed? You don't have a team. You're here by yourself today. You don't have a team, people following you around.
I'm here by myself. I live by myself. I get dressed by myself. I don't have no one helping me. People think I sit like this all day long.
Okay, you just sit like this but, in the room. Just say that.
Unfortunately, bills will not let me do that. School will not let me do that. So I have not one job, but I have two jobs. I have a 2-year-old granddaughter that I take care of. So that's the reason why this hand is shorter, because when she came, I decided to cut them.
Yeah.
So I could do the baby stuff.
She asked her back.
You're going to know about that soon.
I know. I bet she's always like, scratch my back. Yeah. Well, thank you so much again for seriously sharing your story. And
okay.
I think it's cool.
Oh, thank you so much.
And best of luck with that finishing of that master's
degree. Oh, yes. We're going to get that master's degree.
Yes. You got it. All